Back in 1978, Wayne Cilento got a big break when Bob Fosse featured him in his hit musical Dancin'. Now he's bringing the dance show back to the boards. Let's send it out to Paul Wontorek.
That's right, Tamsin. Cilento is rebooting the sexy Fosse classic with an incredible new company of dancers. I got to visit him at New 42nd Street Studios to find out more.
You are in rehearsals for Dancin', bringing back Dancin', and I was thinking about it. 45 years ago, right now, you were in rehearsals for the original Dancin'.
Absolutely.
Working with Bob Fosse on an original musical that I think he was really passionate about. What was that like? What was that time like, working with that man who was such a big part of your life?
That time was a really great progressive time for me because I just got out of Chorus Line.
Yeah.
I went and I did the act with Liza, and I missed the auditions. And then while we were rehearsing to go open on Broadway, Graziella had worked out an audition for me and told Bob, you have to see him. So I ran from the rehearsal hall at the Minskoff Theater. Do you remember
that? The rehearsal room.
Yeah, rehearsal room.
You said, hang on, Liza, I'll be right back.
I did, lunch. I ran over there, and then Annie and Bob were there, and they gave me steps, and I danced with Bob, sang, and kept on raising my key like a crazy man. I said thank you, and I left.
Can I stop you for 1 second? In the first minute of this interview, you mentioned so many legends that were a part of your life. You know what I mean? Bob Fosse, Graziella Danielle, Anne Rankin.
Totally.
I mean, it's so crazy.
It is crazy.
And Liza Minnelli. I mean, all these people.
I know.
That's why we're here. I love this.
Cilento's career was filled with boldface Broadway names from the start, and now he's become one himself. His first big moment, playing Mike in the original cast of A Chorus Line, who memorably sings, I Can Do That.
I stuff shoes with extra socks, run 7 blocks, and nothing flat. Hell, I can do that. I can do that.
Now he's best known as a Tony-winning choreographer, who has staged hit musicals including The Who's Tommy, How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying, Aida, and Wicked. But these days, he's focused on the show that earned him a Tony nomination as a performer, Dancin'. With Fosse's daughter, Nicole, keeping an eye on the project, performances start at the Music Box Theater on March 2nd.
So let's talk about the original Dancin'. When I was a kid, one of my earliest memories of Broadway is walking around the theater district and seeing those Dancin' posters, which scared the heck out of me.
Yeah.
That image was crazy.
You like mean the disjointed thing?
Yeah, the disjointed bodies twisted. I was like, what is this show?
Exactly.
And it was really such a hot show. And to me, it was kind of the epitome of that late 70s Broadway scene. What was it like to actually be on stage? And also, it led to a Tony nomination for featured actor for you, which is fantastic.
It was a killer.
A killer show.
It was like a nonstop killer show.
Yeah.
I mean, it was no joke. And plus the fact he decided to put me in every single number. It was such a new entity, you know, dance concert format, 3 acts on Broadway, which was never done before.
Right.
Just about us, dancers, and music that he decided to pick, and styles that he wanted to do and experiment with. It was, you know, it was just unbelievable to be in that situation. I think a lot of people do this style of Bob Fosse.
Yes.
I mean, all the pop stars, like there's Beyonce and the whole bunch of people, Michael Jackson and everything that, you know, he was such a great influence on people. What I've learned doing this show is that, because I started like really looking at his career and who he was as a man and as a dancer, because you kind of fall into the very specific part of Bob, the sexy part, this still part, you know, seductive part, the finger, the shoulder, the eye, you know, that. But then there's this explosive part of Bob Fosse that, you know, people don't see. I want to get the essence of him, not only just do Dancin', because, you know, that was a very important thing that I stayed true to that, and his numbers and always his choreography. It's all about his choreography. But I wanted to do the influence of him as a film director, choreographer. So I thought maybe we do a set that's like a soundstage and it's like scaffolding, like all that jazz, and keep that, all of that texture and stuff that he's done, and just bring in dancing as if he was maybe filming it, or just doing numbers from dancing in this, a different environment, not so much a concert environment.
Right.
So that's how I was figuring, how do I do this 41 years later and make it relevant for today's generation and make Bob Fosse, you know, come back? What would he have done technology wise, lighting wise, idea wise? How would he push those buttons? And he was always ahead of the curve. Hopefully I did that, and I also gave the audience the essence of who that man was as a brilliant choreographer and dancer.
Tell me about assembling the group of dancers for Dancin' in 2023.
It was interesting and exciting, to tell you the truth, because it wasn't like I locked myself into a certain body type. I was looking whoever was interesting and could really dance. Just beautiful group of young people that will instill that energy and love of dance into Bob's work again.
This March will be your 50th anniversary on Broadway.
It's been a long time, huh?
Yeah. When I look at your career, one thing that I'm really impressed with is how you always remain very hip and relevant. You started as a very 70s career, right? But the things you've done in the 80s, the projects you worked on, and then in the 90s with Tommy and, you know, Wicked and Holler If You Hear Me, it's pretty impressive. Yeah. And I want to know, what's your secret? How do you stay so...
You know, I was so terrified. And, you know, I didn't want to become a Broadway baby just doing Broadway kind of choreography. I think because I had a little bit of an edge and a feisty attitude, I kind of like try to stay on top of it. And I think it's because I'm a dancer and I'll always be a dancer. I mean, I'm torturing myself now because I just want to get on the floor and dance, but I'm so old. So my body just doesn't want to do it, but I will trick myself into getting up one of these days soon. But I think I just stayed on top of what was happening.
Isn't Wicked such a crazy gift in your life?
Such a gift.
Wicked, the gift that keeps giving.
I mean, as a choreographer, that is the gift. I don't think I'll ever have a show as big as that again. I mean, it's a phenomenon. Like, I had A Chorus Line, and I had Dancin', and I have Wicked. I mean, it's like shocking to think that I had those moments in my life.